So let's understand why service discovery is required. So if you look into the traditional distributed system, what happens over here is you have a client and the client in turn will connect to multiple servers, right? So in this case, we know the location of the servers and mostly it is a static IP address, right? So if it is a static IP address, we can have the static IP address configured in the property file and the client can access the property file and it can connect to the different services, right? So there is no problem in this, right? So in case of microservice architecture, there is a little bit of complexity in discovering the service. Let's understand what the complexity is, right? So in case of microservice architecture, you have a client. The client in turn goes and connect to different servers, right? The servers in turn will have multiple services, right? So now, since it is a microservice distributed system, what happens here is you have a mechanism to auto scale up or auto scale down, right? So in this case, what happens is the IP address of the system gets keep on changing, right? So it is not a static IP address, right? If it is not a static IP address, how will the client know the IP address? So that is how we are going to introduce a new component called service registry, right? So service registry is nothing but it is a database which has all the available instance which has been registered, and it provides two APIs primarily. One is the management API where the servers can go and register their instances into that. And the second thing is the client can query that API and figure out what IP address or what instances available for the client to use it, correct? And also there are other important features within the service registry. Let's see one by one. So service registry should be fault tolerant, correct? So let's say you have one service registry and if it fails, so in this case, what happens is the client will not be able to discover the service. At the same time, you have to make sure the service registry is highly available, right? How do you do that? You can have a service registry deployed into the clustered environment so that, you know, if one service registry goes down, you can have a mechanism to find out another service registry and make use of it, right? So that is, we have to be very careful when you use the service registry, right? So now on top of that, when the service registry has all the information, all the services can go and register into the service registry, right? So once the service registry has that information, client can go and query with the query API. And once it notes the instance, it can directly go and connect to the different services based on the output from the query parameter or based on the output from the query string, correct? Let's also talk about the discovery patterns, right? So we have two discovery patterns to identify or to discover the services. One is client-side discovery pattern and other one is the server-side discovery pattern. In terms of client-side service pattern, what happens is you have a client. The client in turn connects to different servers or different services, right? The services goes and registers or itself registers within the service registry, and the client can use the query to get the different instance and it can make use of the different services, correct? That is client-side discovery pattern. Whereas in terms of server-side discovery pattern, the client has a very minimal role. So client in turn connects to the load balancer and the load balancer in turn connects to the different servers or different services, right? So services in turn go and register to the self-registry, right? So here, if you look into that, the client is not going to make an actual connection to the service registry. What happens here is load balancer is going to query the service registry. And once the load balancer has that information about the different instances, it can go and connect to the different services, right? So here the load balancer plays an important role in the server side discovery pattern, right? So all your logic algorithm has to go into the load balancer level to discover the services or to balance the different servers, correct? That is what we call it as a server-side discovery pattern, right? So now let's see how to register the services or instances to the service registry. So there are two types of registering mechanism. Let's see one by one. The first one is a self-registration. In this, what happens is you will have the servers or the services running in the different locations and they go and register to the service registry by themselves. So that is called self-registration, right? The second type of registration is called third-party registration. In this, what happens is you have a service registry and you have a server running across the globe, right? Here we are introducing a new component called register. So register, what it does is it goes and connects to the different service registry and it registers different service instance, right? So it uses the methods like register, heartbeat, and register, etc. Earlier, it was a self-registration where the server itself takes care of registering itself. But here you are using a third-party component called register to do the registration operations, right? So now it also does one more operation where it keeps on pings the different servers across the globe, and it makes sure it is really healthy and it keeps on running, right? So let's understand, like, you know, if the server or service is not running, it has to unregister, right? So that is why it keeps on doing the heartbeat mechanism to make sure the server is running or not. So if it is not running, it immediately goes and unregisters that, right? So one important difference, if you look between the self-registration and the third-party registration, is in case of self-registration, you have to write a code in a service to make sure you just connect to the service registry and go and register the corresponding service to the service registry, right? Whereas in third-party registration, you don't want to write a code. You can make use of the third-party components or third-party services to register your instance or services into the service registry, right? One more interesting thing over here is, if you look into the overall service discovery mechanism, the service registry is a key component over here, right? So now there are certain cases, like if you want to get an environment into AWS, and if you keep on spinning the new instances, automatically they provide a service registry where your new instances get added into the service registry. So you don't have an extra work, right? Now let's say you have a mechanism where you have to build your own service registry, then you can use the software components like Netflix Eureka, right? So you can install, and you need a little bit of work to make sure that Eureka instance is deployed in the cluster and it gets added into the different services, or you can use different APIs provided by service registry to register your services, right? That is another way of doing it, right?